The beast was silent. "Tell us the reason," urged Cap'n Bill.
"Well, it's the Isle of the Magic Flower," answered the Kalidah, "and we don't care much for magic. If you hadn't had a magic leg instead of a meat one, you couldn't have knocked me over so easily and stuck this wooden pin through me."
"I've been to the Magic Isle," said the Glass Cat, "and I've watched the magic flower bloom, and I'm sure it's too pretty to be left in that lonely place, where only beasts prowl around it and no else sees it. So we're going to take it to the Emerald City."
"I don't care," the beast replied in a surly tone. "We Kalidahs would be just as contented if there wasn't a flower in our forest. What good are the things, anyhow?"
"You don't like pretty things?" asked Trot.
"No."
"You ought to admire my pink brains, anyhow," declared the Glass Cat. "They're beautiful, and you can see 'em work."
The beast only growled in reply,
and Cap'n Bill, having now cut all his logs to a proper size, began to roll them to the water's edge and fasten them together.
End of Chapter 9.
Chapter 10. Stuck Fast. The day was nearly gone when at last the raft was ready.
"It ain't so very big," said the old sailor, "but I don't weigh much, and you, Trot, don't weigh half as much as I do, and the glass pussy don't count."
"But it's safe, isn't it?" inquired the girl.
"Yes, it's good enough to carry us to the island and back again, and that's about all we can expect of it."
Saying this, Cap'n Bill pushed the raft into the water, and when it was afloat, stepped upon it and held out his hand to Trot, who quickly followed him. The Glass Cat boarded the raft last of all.